Hey, 42 here. Currently there are 118 elements that we have discovered and logged on the periodic table. Elements are strange things, simply adding or removing a single proton from the atom's nucleus of an element completely changes it and essentially makes it a new element. Here's the weirdest elements from the periodic table that seem to defy the laws of physics. First up is gallium, a soft metal that's sometimes used in electronics, but it has a unique party trick. It safely melts in human hands, then re-solidifies again once it drops below its 30 degrees Celsius melting point. In the early 20th century, a popular prank amongst chemists at university was to smelt gallium into utensils, then watch as their classmates' knife and fork melted away from their hands as they ate. But if you think a metal becoming a liquid at room temperature is weird, how about a metal being a gas at room temperature? Copernicium is a highly radioactive synthetic metal. It is one of the weirdest and most elusive elements because of two reasons. Firstly, it decays extremely fast. It has an astonishingly short half-life of just 29 seconds, so it doesn't stick around for very long. And secondly, it is a gas at room temperature. Both these factors make it extremely difficult for scientists to study. Subsequently, we still don't know very much about this elusive substance. Curium is an extremely radioactive substance that was named after Marie Curie. Only a few kilograms of curium are produced each year, because it doesn't have very many uses. However, it was used on a Mars mission in an alpha proton X-ray spectrometer. But what makes this element so unique is that it's so radioactive that it actually glows in the dark. Next up is francium, a naturally occurring element named after France. Francium is one of the alkaline metals, all of which are extremely volatile. But francium is the most reactive of all the alkaline metals. At its most stable isotope, it has a very short half-life of just 22 minutes and is unbelievably rare. It usually pops into existence one atom at a time, then disappears almost instantaneously. It is estimated that there are only about 20 grams of francium on the planet at any one time. Scientists aren't even able to procure a sample of francium large enough so that it's visible to the naked eye. Therefore, studying it is almost impossible. But we do know that when put into water, the reaction would be spectacularly dangerous, considering that the next most reactive alkali metal is cesium, which explodes when it touches water. However, francium is considerably more volatile than cesium, and just the moisture in the air alone would cause francium to explode spectacularly. Next up is a group of eight different elements, all relatively new to the periodic table. They are all man-made, they all have similar names, and were all discovered in the exact same manner, by scientists bombarding atoms at one element with atoms of another element. This separates them into completely new elements, but only for a fraction of a second. The first to be discovered, unumbium, was first created in 1996 in a lab in Germany. None of these elements have been seen for more than a second, and their inclusion on the periodic table still remains under investigation. Bismuth is the heaviest non-radioactive metal. Actually, it's very, very, very slightly radioactive, but it has a half-life billions of times longer than the current age of the universe, so for argument's sake, it's fair to say that it's completely stable. Bismuth is used in medicine and cosmetics, but it has a unique attribute. It is diamagnetic, which means it emits a magnetic field in the opposite direction to any externally applied magnetic field. In layman's terms, if you put a magnet between two lumps of bismuth, it will levitate indefinitely. You probably imagine sulfur as a yellow rock, but it can actually change to an array of different colours under different conditions. One of the weirdest such examples can be seen if you melt sulfur. It turns from a solid yellow rock to a blood red liquid. Also, just as cool, if you burn sulfur, it produces a neon blue flame. But sulfur has a disgusting side too. It's responsible for the odour of rotten eggs, garlic, onions, and many other nasty smells. In fact, most things that smell bad have some sulfur in there somewhere. Next up is helium. It's a colourless, odourless, tasteless, inert gas, which means it doesn't react with other elements. Its boiling and melting points are the lowest of any element, at an unimaginably low -272.2 degrees Celsius. Helium turns into a superfluid, which exhibits a unique property. If you pour helium in its superfluid form into a vessel, it seems to defy gravity and creep up the walls of the container and pour over the rim to try and reach a warmer place, where it will eventually evaporate. But by far the thing that makes helium so damn extraordinary is this. If it wasn't for this next element, you wouldn't be watching this video right now. I am of course talking about silicon, a crucial component in all computer chips and most electronics. It's even got an entire valley named after it in California. It's also responsible for silky white beaches being the most common component in sand. Oh, and don't forget breast implants too. It's one of the most common elements on Earth. About 27% of the Earth's crust is made up of silicon. Silicon is a remarkable element because it's largely responsible for the technological revolution of the past 30 years. And finally, it may not be particularly strange, but it is arguably the most amazing element. The element I'm talking about is carbon. It is the most essential element to support life. It is the building block of everything living. DNA, proteins, cells, coal, pencils, diamonds, the air you breathe and the food you eat are all made up from carbon, as well as countless other things. Carbon comprises 20% of the weight of all living organisms. To put it simply, if it wasn't for carbon, we wouldn't be here, and neither would the universe as we know it. So, for that reason alone, it deserves some attention. Thanks for the view. Subscribe for more 42.